I don't need them, but sometimes, you know, I bought them at the dollar store.
Amen.
Let's all stand for the reading of the word. Not in honor to me, but in honor to the word of God. Praise be to God. Matthew 10. And when he had called his 12 disciples to him, he gave them power over unclean spirits to cast them out and to heal all kinds of sickness and all kinds of disease. Number 5. These 12 Jesus sent out and commanded them, saying, do not go into the way of the Gentiles, and do not enter a city of the Samaritans. 6. But go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. And as you go, preach, saying, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, cast out demons. Freely you have received, freely you shall give. Glory to God. Heavenly Father, I thank you this morning, my Lord, for the honor and privilege, my Lord, hallelujah, for being able to bring your word. I thank you to know, my Lord, only you know how happy I am, my Lord, to be doing this today, on this day, my Lord, that it was your will, my Lord, because everything that comes to us, my Lord, it is your will, my Lord. Let your will be done in each and every one of our lives on this day and every day until you come. Bless this word, anoint our minds and our hearts, my Lord, hallelujah, so we may not only be hearers of the word, but we may be doers of your word. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. You may be seated.
Glory to God.
A disciple is a learner, one who follows both the teaching and the teacher. The word disciple is used first of the 12 and later to all of us, Christians that are here, because we are called to be disciples. We are also called to bring the word of God to all those that don't know this word. God is not looking for age, right? Because you see children, everybody. He's not looking for age, race, color, religion. Only people that are willing. Notice that I didn't say people that are able, right? Yeah. Because you are able, sometimes you learn to trust in yourself. And God doesn't want that. He wants you to trust in Him, praise living God. Hallelujah. But that are willing. You have to be willing to do His will. Praise living God. Since we have reasoning, our parents call us. Do this, do that, don't do this, don't do that. And I forgot to tell you, the message is the call of God.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
That his ears are empty. It goes through one way and it comes out the other. You know? What happened to you? Children of God, and we were called for a purpose to serve.
Aleluya.
Everybody, from the king to the animals, everybody, everybody. I heard that from Joyce Meyer. I didn't make it up. So he lived in the temple, and God was calling him. And he went to Eli. Did you call me? He went to the priest. No, I didn't call you. He went, go back to sleep. Right? And the other one that wasn't took it either. Eli, because his sons were doing really bad things in the temple. Glory to God. So, you know, God wanted to bring a word forward. And it was a word of judgment through Samuel, the prophet of God. So he went again. God spoke to him. But he couldn't understand. So he went to the priest again. Did you call me? No, I didn't call you. Praise God, Jesus. The third time, and he went to the priest again. And then Eli, because his hearing wasn't sensitive to the word of God, so we have to have all our senses, all our senses in tune.
Yes.
Come on, Sarah, help me here. Taste, smell, touch, hear, and see. Oh, praise the Lord. Glory to God. I'm amazed at myself. So we have to have all those in tune, because we have to taste and see how wonderful our Lord tastes. A lot of people that have come to the Lord in their later years realized and said, oh, why did I miss so many years instead of serving the Lord when I was younger? But we have time now, because you're probably going to get upset, but I'm 70 years old. I was January 15th. And now is when he's going like, bajo a mí. I mean, se está luciendo el Señor conmigo. I don't know. How to say that in English? Like, he's like...
showing off.
Oh, guys! So he's showing off, you know? He's showing off. But he doesn't want me to be on the surface. Because in order for him to plant something in your hands, you have to dig in deeper.
That's right.
And a lot of years he's been telling me, I want you to go deeper, deeper, deeper. But Sister Lydia has been staying on the surface. He wants all of us here, to go deeper, to seek him.
Amen.
Because if we seek him, if we draw nearer to him, he will draw nearer to us.
Amen.
Praise the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Four times Jesus called God, not Jesus, God called Samuel. And then Eli said, well, go back and lay down, and when he speaks to you again, say, speak, for your servant
is listening.
He listens, hears, listens, right? But it was God talking to him. Who has he been calling here? How many times has he been calling us? I know he's calling me to dig deeper.
Yes,
every one of us has that special assignment. Only you know and I know what that special assignment is. We all have a calling. We all have been called. We all have an assignment to fulfill. In 1 Samuel 3:19, it says that none of the words that Samuel spoke fell to the ground. Ninguna de las palabras que Samuel habló cayeron al piso. Because God backed up all of the words that Samuel said.
Yes.
And nowadays, there are so many people speaking that you don't know. Who is speaking? Is God talking to you? Is it flesh? Is it emotion? What is that is talking to you? That's why Sister Lydia and everyone here needs that special relationship with the Lord, so we can differentiate who's talking to us. Who is giving us word of wisdom, or who is giving us word of destruction? But the calling is for all of us. Because God has been calling.
Yes.
Remember, I don't know, but when he created Adam and Eve, and then they committed, we're not going to go into who, the he, the she, the what, you know, they committed. And then when God called them, they hid. Why did they hide? Because they knew that they were naked and they had done something wrong. They did not listen to what God had told them to do. Glory to God.
Amen.
So do not belittle yourself. We were worth the blood of Christ. God bless you.
Amen.